Squid Game is a Korean TV show that went from
zero to hero in no time flat. Zero to hero, just like that.
On the Netflix popularity charts, and honestly, I'm not complaining. Squid Game as a whole is a depressing, gory, philosophical, disturbing, and a fascinating, thought-provoking drama with some
that's groovy, baby.
And somehow slight similarities to Fall Guys. Oh, you don't remember it? It's probably because of a little game called and you can't deny it because even the Fall Guys devs knows it. It's 9 episodes that are about an hour long each, so it's time for some lightning reviews. Episode 1 is about a desperate guy who's very poor named Gi-hun, who joins a mysterious game with money to win money, and things go wrong. Bum bum bum! This episode introduces most of the characters, but the ending was so beautifully shot. Episode 2, the players are released from the game as they wanted, but they realize their lives are actually better in the game. This episode adds a ton of humanity to the characters, and a lot of personality to each one. And it also has a lot of similarities with another K-drama, Parasite, which, if you haven't heard of, I think that's impossible, because it won, like, all the awards a year or two ago. Episodes 3, 4, and 5 are a mix of Knives Out and the Fall Guys elements of the show. That's really all I could say. I think episode 5 is the weakest of the whole series, mostly because it's just really slow. But 3 and 4 are just character development and more of the show. Episode 6 is the saddest thing I've seen since Captain Boomerang's death in the Suicide Squad. It's so sad, yet so amazingly done by everybody that worked on it. I can't get over it. Episodes 7 and 8 are kind of like the grand finales. I was on the edge of my seat. It's sad, but not like episode 6 sad. And it's so, the climax and the build-up, it all comes together, and it's so good. Episode 9 is the final episode. It's so good. It's so good. The ending was so well done by everybody that worked on it. The actors, the musicians, the directors, the everything, the editing, the pacing, everything just went together like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Or actually no, because there's so many elements, it's more like a fruit salad. But like a really, really posh and fancy fruit salad. It's overpriced, but like it's worth it because it's just good. And the amount of emotions that just overwhelm me in the finale is pretty much when I knew, yeah, it's pretty good. It's kind of confusing, I think, for a lot of parts. So spoiler alert. If you didn't understand, I guess I'll explain the finale. So, in episode 6, there was a super sad part where the old man died. That, he didn't really die, it was a shot fired, I presume, around him. And what he was saying in the finale is, he did live a life, but as somebody who was rich and was into all that, they got bored. So they created the games. And so people funded it. So where did he get all that money? Investors and his own money and I presume other people's money. And so it's kind of just like that. And the ending, I think that if they really wanted to make a season 2, they should. And it would be really interesting because the ending reminded me a lot of John Wick. And it was really, really well done. I think that's all I could say. But just, yeah. So, if you're still here, why not like and subscribe? It'd be pretty cool. Anyways, yeah. Bye. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me play forevermore. You're all I long for, all I wish for and adore. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Subscribe.